Helen, welcome to Off the Press. This is the program where we dissect the headlines, take a look at them, and make sense of it. This morning, with me to do so are two gentlemen, Mr. Olojede Gbolahan, who's a political analyst.
Good to be here.
Good to have you. And Dr. Femi Idowu, Adegoke, also was a political analyst and was here yesterday. Good. Always good to have you both coming here to help us understand all that we've got. Today we have several papers, four or five, I think, but we'll begin with the Nation newspaper. It will be displayed. And the big story there is Buhari can rule Nigeria from anywhere, says Oshiomhole. Anywhere, in fact, he says. Now, court holds Operation Show ID hearing for November 18th. That story is on page 40. Marking date to demolish illegal rehab center, suspects for trial. That's on page 5. EFCC may now will jump bail if granted. Family to testify on page 8. And then Bayelsa and Kogi, of course, the elections there. PDP planning to buy votes, says Leon. Police promise adequate security for Kogi electorate. INEC deploys sign language interpreters in polling units. That's fair enough. On page 10, you find the stories and more there. And then Deep Onshore Act Amendment, a great step. That's on the front page, but it's continued on page 7. A minister orders court of data. NCC operators get deadline to do so. That's also on the front page, continued also on page 8. Now, millions gone in Lagos market fire. That happened yesterday in Balogun. You can see the picture story there. And the main story is on page 6 of the Nation newspaper. Air probes airpiece plane in return. AIB probes airpiece plane air return. That's on page 8, I beg your pardon. And Senate sacks NDDC's interim management on page 7. Now, government and EU defer on $25 billion remittance. That's on the front page, very tiny there, but it's continued on page 34. Quadri upbeat despite draw. That's on the front page. Something on sports, I believe. But it's continued on page 47. And then finally, panel on social media regulation. Front page also continued on page 40. Now let's look at the back of the Nation. Also, we have some columnists there, Festus Erie and Pa and the Vice Presidency. And the other part is the global spread of protests by Ni. This, we'll grab a copy of and find out. Let's come to the front page. So, Gbolahan,
okay,
let's start with you.
A few comments on the court halt Operation Show ID.
Mm-hmm. Happy about that?
I'm delighted. I know this is still a temporary thing. Mm-hmm. It's like an injunction. There will still be a proper hearing after a while. But why I'm delighted at this junction is that at least this initiative will have to take a pause.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the pause will give the operators some benefit to go back and think
through
deeply about what they think they want to do. If I get stopped in the US and say, oh, by the police, and say, your ID, if I present my ID, the guy has a handheld or he has a device in his car. So he runs that. Driver's license. You can even tell whether you have a charge that you have not paid.
Hmm.
If I give an ID to a soldier in Nigeria, how does he know? How does he validate that ID? Is it because he's wearing a uniform that you get? Does that confer you an ability to identify
a
valid or an invalid ID card? So the intentions must be praised. If the intention is, okay, you have terrorists who are living their sleeper cells in the north and are believed to be going to the south. Mm. It's important. We need to fish them out and, you know, have them arrested and stop that trend. But operationalizing that intent is disastrous in conception, in thinking. It doesn't even present the army properly, present them as if, I don't want to use the wrong words,
yeah,
but that level of thinking, we need to step back from it.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't present us well at all.
Mm.
So they can do it, but the world of today thrives on intelligence. Security has gone beyond soldiers' uniform on the street.
Sure.
It's even beyond, it's not those things that you can see. America didn't have to go to the Syrian northern border and started doing Operation ID before they could deal with one of the stronger terrorists stronghold in that place.
Mm-hmm.
So intelligence is the name of the game, and that is what I believe the army need to think about, not stopping everybody on the street of Lagos and asking for ID card. Mm-hmm. Like you cannot even identify if they give you the ID card.
Because no ID card is written terrorist and non-terrorist.
These terrorists are sophisticated, as we are saying. They will be the first one to get ID card. Now, you can get ID card down the road.
That's the case.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So what are we talking about?
Okay, good to hear that they are putting a halt on that for now. So which other story?
Well, do you need want not to say more.
You just agree.
No, I agree with what you say, but the truth is that we need to rework our process. Mm. That's all he's saying. The process has to be tight.
Mm.
Because these terrorists, they are, or whoever they want to fish out, they work on intelligence as well.
They are smart.
And they are very smart. And they can be steps ahead of you.
Mm. Okay, so let's go to which other story?
Where he can rule from?
Yeah, he can rule from anywhere.
Yes.
Anywhere, even in the...
No,
let's not say.
He's a president, anywhere he goes. Mm. He's a president of Nigeria, no doubt about that. But the problem I have, or the issue I have, with him signing bill in United Kingdom, is the foundation of him being there. He left the shores of Nigeria to Saudi Arabia. And we were told that from Saudi Arabia is embarking on
a
2 weeks private visit.
I know you don't like this part of the private visit.
I don't. You are no longer private.
You said so earlier, but
yeah,
well.
You are no longer private the moment you accept to serve public.
But Femi, are you saying that, what's the issue with the private visits, really?
Private means nothing. That's it. And he's our president. Are you going for L check? Are you going on an annual leave?
You're concerned about the specificity.
So yes, he needs to let us know. So Nigerians, so now look at the noise making the rounds, the news making the rounds is he's gone for his health, that he has ailment. That's what people are saying. I don't believe that.
So it gives room for speculation.
Exactly.
When you're number one public officer, you're going to lose some element of your privacy. So if you're staying in the UK and you're the one cutting the check from your personal account, and you say, I'm going on vacation, and you, nobody cares. But if the taxpayers are paying, and you are the number one public officer, it is just natural that you should tell us.
It's just as right.
Yeah, you see, we just have there's what we call the right to know. We are the one paying. Shouldn't we know if we're paying?
We should.
We should know.
I agree. Yeah. We agree with you.
And you see, he did not hand over when he was leaving. And because he did not hand over, that means he remains the president wherever he is. Mm-hmm. If he handed over, then he's not president. The person he handed over to becomes the president, you know. But now that he did not hand over, he's still the president. And if you need to sign a law, when he's still the president, he's the right person to sign the law. So no illegality has been committed in the real sense of it.
Yeah.
But it's not everything that is legal that is expedient or wise.
Yeah.
You know, I would have thought that if we're not, he can make better use of the vice president that he has.
Mm-hmm.
That guy is a son, is a professor of law, and the matter on the table is about law. So the value add that we could get from that, we probably missed it in the mix of the politics of the old thing. So, but that's another discussion entirely.
Which is quite well. All right. So, which other story? Mayna, he's ill.
They're always ill.
I mean, there was a police. There was a report. You know, there was a medical report handed over in the courtroom.
Before we came on here, myself and Mr. Gbolahan, we were talking about it. This is the card they play every time. As soon as they get caught and they are to be tried, they are now having one form of sickness or ailment.
It could be psychological. It could be well.
Yeah, but they play. Are Nigerian fools? You play the same card to us every time.
But you see,
don't forget, in 2015, when was the PDP guy who fell in court? What's his name again? $400 million.
Me too.
All of a sudden, he was very ill and hearty during the election campaign, going everywhere. But the moment he began his trial, he became sick.
Could be stress and fatigue. I'm just saying.
It's a possibility.
Okay. Now, this one, the two, is another one staring us in the face.
There's a report.
So they're just telling. See, Nigerians, I've said it here and I'll keep saying it. We are citizens of this country. We need to organize ourselves and begin to ask very serious questions about the kind of governance we have, the kind of people who are ruling this country.
The processes.
Yes, we need to ask those questions. And because if we don't ask now, we will wait again. By 2022, another process starts for election. And 2023, we have the same bunch of people in power. INEC is not doing anything now. They're not giving, nobody's collecting a PVC now. It's 3 months to the election. They will now roll out timetable for people who have not taken their PVC to come and take it.
They've been asking people to go collect it.
When did you? I have not heard any jingle.
I'm telling you now. They have. Anyways, I understand what you mean by saying there should be remote preparation.
I'm not even complaining about the INEC. I'm talking about the people now. Mm. We as a people, we need to begin to get serious with our governance system.
Questions.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so we also need to shift the base of our emphasis when it comes to anti-corruption fight from post-event to a prevention situation. Yeah. You see, when people have already taken billions, they have a huge resources at their disposal. They can fight the entire system. What is medical report if I have a billion in my account? What is medical report? If I want it to come from abroad, say, if I will procure it, what are we talking about? So we need to move into that prevention mode where we make sure people cannot steal the money. Because when they steal and they steal big, they will fight the entire system, judiciary, SAN, everybody. Case may be in court for, we don't know how long.
God knows how long. That's unfortunate, but it's a big point you've made there. Just about the fire, very unfortunate incident that happened yesterday. I don't know if you got to see the news. You know, the traders there were complaining that this same place every time, every year, and it's almost, one is almost wondering, is it a sabotage or is it just natural occurrence or combination of so many things put together?
Have you been to some of this part before?
Well, not exactly.
When you go to those buildings, you will know that there is no, you don't require any sabotage. The people are self-sabotaging.
Yeah.
The way those buildings are put together, you have buildings that in Lagos Island, some of these business buildings are such that I can be in my own room and I can shake someone from the next building by stretching my hand out of the window. That is how close some of those buildings are. The wiring is scary when you enter some of those buildings, and you have to bend your head to ensure that one generator that has been connected somewhere, the wiring it doesn't hit your head with naked wire and all that stuff. So they are all disasters waiting to happen.
That's unfortunate, really. That's unfortunate. We'll move on very quickly. And that's the video being displayed there. Thank you very much, our production crew. But that's unfortunate, and we understand that property worth millions have been destroyed in that, and a policeman was killed as a result. Anyways, we'll move on. Thank you, guys. We'll move on to the other newspapers now in the interest of time. And we'll have the Punch newspaper. It says telecom firms get 5 days to stop illegal deductions. I completely agree they should do this. I don't even understand all of those messages. You just wake up to one message any day. That story is on page 26 after whining. It's on page 26. Now, labor rights states set for minimum wage negotiations. And that's on page 23. Airpeace makes air return over engine failure. Page 23 as well. Corruption persists despite Buhari's efforts, says SGF Sagai. And that's on page 11. Page 11. License cancellation. Federal government gives discos December 7th deadline. And that's on page 26. And court stops operation positive identification, thankfully, on page 7. Now, signing of bill in UK. Nigerians attack Buhari. But they just said he can, well, can govern from anywhere at all. So Buhari now prefers working overseas, according to MBA. It is dictatorial, lawless, according to Afenifere and Ohaneze. Now, presidents can work from any part of the world, and that's by presidency and, of course, Adams Oshiomhole. No letter on power transmission to Yemi Oshibajo, according to reps there. And that's on page 2. The story is contained on page 2. And again, the picture story of the fire yesterday from Balogun markets on page 4. Akwa Ibom University sacks 8 lecturers for alleged sex offense. Good step, if you ask me. On page 11, Emefiele demands secret grilling by Senate panel. On page 9, Senate confirms NDDC board members reject Akpabio panel. On page 7, Makinde inaugurates wife as HIV board chair. Okay, 170 million naira for past wise questions. That's on page 10 and 19. Grieving husband dies 24 hours after wife's demise, and that's so unfortunate. That's unfortunate. And I can see a picture of a child there, so he must have left some children or a child, as the case may be. The story is on pages 4 and 5 of the Punch newspaper. No going back, Edo, 14 lawmakers tell Obaseki. Oshiomhole shuns questions on governor, and that's on page 18. Two stories from here. We shall take only two stories from here. Anyone want to start first? Nigerians attack Buhari. Yes, we're done with that. Okay,
yeah, so we've had some discussion around mm-hmm. that.
The minimum wage? Anything on
minimum
that?
Minimum wage is a good story to quickly talk about. Mm-hmm. Now it's going to the state. It's been settled at the federal level. And I think this is where the real fight will be.
They've already told us that they can only pay based on their capacity.
Exactly.
Is that like a defense?
It's a defense. It is more or less like preparing the minds of labor. As you are coming to the state, too, this is what you're likely to meet. And it's a starting point for the negotiations. Because labor will come with what they have agreed at the center. And that is supposed to form the base, is the barest minimum of what is expected of the state. But you will have a number of states who will have a problem with that. And I can assure you that labor will also fight. There are revenue problems, no doubt about that. But you see, the actions and activity of some of these political actors at the states does not make their case easy to plead. You have people who are appointing special advisors to their wives. They have two wives, and they will appoint two for this one, two for that one. Then labor is now saying, come and pay me 30,000. You say, I don't have money. You know, we are not making revenues. Those kind of things make their case difficult before labor. So people are seeing wastages all over the whole place.
That's true.
And they say, come and pay me. You say, I don't have money to pay you.
That's unfortunate. Yeah. Any thoughts on that?
No.
Okay. We'll actually just read out the rest papers because of time. I'm so sorry, but that's what's going to happen. And we have this day, very quickly, Barkindo predicts stability in oil markets in 2020 on the front page. Relief as court orders army to suspend operation positive identification. Yes, there's quite relief there. On page 5, and then concerns mount over integrity of IOCs, how Abakiari, Lawan work together on Police Service Commission amendment. And discussing matters that you have pictures. And a crisis imminent, labor insists states can't pay below federal government's consequential adjustment. All this you find on the front page. Any thoughts on Kerry, or we just call it a wrap then?
You know, blaming the IOCs.
Okay.
Well, you're blaming IOC for not adjusting your laws. Mm. It is absolute nonsense.
Oh, wow. Both of you said it. It's absolute nonsense.
It is our people should blame ourselves for not amending our own laws. Yes, the IOCs are here to do business. If you said you were going to change how much you would share, and you refused to change it over the years, you're now saying IOC had integrity issues. No, our people have integrity issues.
Okay. So, and that's where we're going to wrap it. Our people have integrity issues, according to both of you, actually agreed.
And so,
thank you. Unfortunately, we have to end it here. Thank you so very much, Mr. Olojede. And thank you, Dr. Femi, for always coming around to help us make sense of this. And that's where we're going to call it a wrap here on Off the Press. We'll continue this the same time tomorrow here on Plus TV Africa. I am Amaka Okoye. Have yourselves a good day.